Since it's not there, you'll be carrying it and then you'll be doing it. You'll be using it like boy everywhere. You'll be moving it. I know. Many of you are from the city. You'll be moving it around and then playing the thing you will do, release the rope. The little rope. Why? The thing we want to grab that thing is out. You don't pull it back down. You're in control. And demon is less than rat. But before God, rat has value than demons. Praise the Lord. So the only language the devil understands is the language of power. Martin Luther, it happened with Spigelsburg and Martin Luther. After having an ethnic meeting all day, God upstairs to his room in his duplex to sleep. All of a sudden, he had a rattling sound downstairs. Tables were falling, things were falling, things were. Now went downstairs to look. So he did say, I thought it was something serious. I didn't know it was suicidal. He left. By the time he got upstairs, he discovered that his bed, where he stood up from to come down to go and look at what is happening downstairs, the bed had been moved. He told him, said, you dearly don't have respect for my bed. Oh, yeah, come back and rearrange the bed. And then Satan had to come and rearrange the bed and put it. Martin Luther and Spindle was good result at the revolution. This is not fable. It's not a myth. True life story. Report it. He said, you don't. You know about some of us. The next thing is, who is the pastor of duty? This one, pastor of duty. What's Baba's number? Hello, Baba. Baba, if you see the thing I see today, I went downstairs and scattered. Before I come up, I'm taking over my bed. You know it? If you call me for that, I say sleep on it. Sleep on it. Sleep on. Let me tell you, no matter what the devil has programmed for you in life, as long as you don't fear, it cannot win. It can never happen. It's even animals. Why you see animals? How God has ordained it is that they must flee from you. I've been in bush for years, and I've seen various animals. As long as you are not afraid, they will go for you. But peradventure, you now pass your level, you begin to pursue them and they recover. Some, like an animal, like lion. Lion will not do anything for you except lion is hungry. It doesn't kill, except it's hungry. Except it's hungry. It is a natural instinct built by God. He made us his own image. All creatures, animals, are meant to respect us. But when I don't see dog now, I'm already urinating on my body. You know, dog deserves fear. And once they see the fear like this, they go. I mean, they go after me, they are beating. So fear not. Fear not about life. Tomorrow will be better. Amen. Pastor, with this economy, with our leader, your destiny is not in the hand of the leader. Your destiny is in the hand of God. And that's why the power to make it be with me. You may not have a dime in your pocket now. It may not seem as if you have what it takes to possess your house this year. But I say in the name of Jesus, I don't know who you are. This same year, you will step in. So the Lord language, Psalm 66 verse 3 again. I like that scripture. Thou, through the greatness of thy power, thy enemies shall submit unto thee. The greatness. Not through the shallowness, not through the moderate, not through the little touch of your power, through the greatness. Power past power. Thank you, Jesus. Know that power, number three. Know that power is in degrees and not in levels. Psalm 45, verses 6 to 7. Ezekiel 47, verses 1 to 14. Now, why do I need the anointing? You know, the word anointing and word power is the same thing. Is that clear? Do you get that?
Yes, sir.
Because I use the word power, anointing, and it's like it's the same thing. Power, anointing, power, anointing. So Holy Spirit is not anointing. Holy Spirit is not power, but he has power. Are you with me? So I may use the word, why do I need anointing? Why do I need power? So the word power, the word anointing, the power of the Holy Spirit, the anointing of the Holy Spirit is the same language. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So why do I need the anointing. Quickly, let me give you a few. Number one, to fulfill purpose on earth. To fulfill purpose on earth. Luke chapter 4, verses 14 to 18. Acts chapter 1, verse 8. You shall see power after the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and you shall be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in Judea, in Samaria, and unto the uttermost part of the earth. Number two, why do I need the anointing? For divine protection. Psalm 105, verses 13 to 15. He rebuked kings for their sakes, saying, touch not my anointed, to my prophet no harm. Now let me say something about the prophet in verse 15. If you look at your Bible very well, you will see the word prophet there is written in small letter P. Small letter what? P. What does that mean? Which means anyone that speaks on behalf of God, whether you testify on behalf of God, whether you do evangelism on behalf of God, whether you stand for God, that is the voice that is whose voice, who speaks for God. It's not the ministry gift. The prophet of the ministry gift is addressed with capital P. No, we have apostle, prophet, evangelist, pastor, teachers. So it's not about the gift. The ministry gift is talking about the people who speak. So the more you reach out for God, I declare and declare, you are secured and protected in grace.
Amen.
For protection. Number three, why do I need the anointing? To exercise authority. To exercise authority. Like I just shared with you about issue of deliverance, issue of ministration, issue of peace. I remember a small baby was brought to our house of recent, a small girl, and said she brings things, was bringing forth muka and stretching and things like that. And when I woke up and I came my wife, I said, look, go, bam, put her. Just put her on my mattress in the bathroom. Just put her there. Within a short while, she just executed a greatness of dance and started being over the place, and that was it. Through the greatness of that power. So, in the same light, I remember someone who came to see me about the case, and I said, I need to cover some chapter. I said, lie down, my bitch. In bed in my bathroom, I just said, in the store, I said, lie down there. And my dad, he discovered he felt as if an electric shock took him over. So he started rolling all over the study. By the time he came out, he said, it's like they have touched me. Not that I lay down, not that I touch, just lie down. Where you have sat, somebody else who is sick should sit there and be healed. Because you carry power, you carry life. You understand? Are you with me? God will do wonders with you and through you and for you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So, exercise authority. In Psalm 110, verse 1 to 3, it says, in the days of thy power, what will happen? Thy people shall be willing. Exercise of authority. To exercise authority. What is authority? Dominion. You say to this good they go, you say to this come, they come. I remember when we were living in Falulu. And we used to do one night every time, we'd be making noise inside the house. So they came one time, the neighbors came and said, they want me to stop doing the all night in the house. I said, no problem. I will stop the all night, but chiefs will come. The same week, some robbers left letter at the gate, at Falulu gate. That's when the was that they are coming. Oh, when God wants to honor you, it's very interesting. He came again, led by Yatemi, the pastor. Why did you stop the prayer? Don't you hear the letter they brought? I said, which letter? Sincerely, I did not know the brother. They are the one who came back to that. That girl, you have to continue the prayer. The father, I'm telling you, I'm not the only pastor on the street, in the close. Now I'm the only one to continue the prayer. Hey, they said they are coming. I said, no, we are not, pastor, we will never pray. We will never pray, sir, pastor. He said, you see, pastor, you see, in the days of Indra, we know we don't know anything. You don't know anything. Now God brought you here. You say, this house you have been living. Nobody has survived here as such. If you wife don't die, husband will die. He's only pastor since 1964. Please, pastor, continue praying. He said that. You never say Satan. God is angry when they brought the letter. Abba. And the following Tuesday, they came in the evening. Those who are coming after abandon their car are running away. They may not come inside like that. They just came to introduce themselves. Dogs came to introduce themselves. So I just carry on my own night. So I move people from door to door. Hey, open the window. Hey! If you come and greet me, thank you for yesterday. I also come and give you more strength. You are doing your prayer. The devil was praying tongues, he was doing it. Listen to me. If somebody said you will not open your committee, whether you agree, we don't want you to do our solution there again. Don't worry. Just tell them. I'm probably small. So when they saw the sample, he says, in the days of thy power, thy people shall be what? They shall be willing. They shall be willing. We are taking over the ghost.
Yeah.
And people will know that God has created some people.
Yeah.
We have been on long-term vacation. Now we are cutting the vacation short.
Yeah.
That's why these things require price. It requires price. Number five, why do I need the anointing? For the preservation of God's blessings in one's life. If you read Psalm 112 from verse 1 to 9, particularly in verse 3, it says, what and riches shall be your house? What brings about that? The anointing. Power for wealth, power to get wealth. Psalm 112, verses 1 to 9, and Psalm 92, verses 10 to 15. It says, you will anoint you with fresh oil, and you will be renewed, your strength shall be renewed like the white ox. Psalm 92, verses 10 to 15. Then what does it take to get it? This more power, what does it take to get it? I remember when we were building church, and my ministerial assistant was a project supervisor. Not that I was an engineer. There is nothing the person cannot do. He's all, everything, all. So he was a site project supervisor. I am the chief. This one that supervises the builder, I was the chief engineer. No money now. Because before we get the engineer safe, it was Wala. One man said, from Ijoro to Ojo Elegba, there is no belong. The church that was most vibrant in the community that we met, they have stopped them from building. They said there's investigation in court. And the man was boasting that he has 250 cases in high court on land matters. I looked and I said, we are paid to the last couple. So how will I tell them that the land we buy become? So I said, we are moving to be open air land. No room. So when it's raining, we put light on by them. Those who have umbrella, put umbrella. When they put umbrella, I moved umbrella. Rain before. I told him, I announced, after 7 days prayer, extension of the weekend, 89 street rows. Announced in the church, I want to kill somebody. If you know this man, so my assistant then said, his son was my classmate at GCI. I said, okay, 3 days. So my staff prevailed on me. And then we went to the man's house. I said, okay, I will satisfy you. When we got to the man's house, they drove us away. I told my assistant, I said, are you satisfied? I said, why would this man do like this? I'm going to say, hey, people are just, I said, he was just grumbling because I was the one driving. I was just in the street. We got back to the church. I rode in 7 days. On the seventh day, the man had an attack. They flew him to the U.S. for treatment. He came back. He still wanted to pursue the case in court. That was the end. Wherever he has gone, I know it is not evil. That was the end. So everybody wanted to build in the church, in the community, started building. Church started springing up. Then when we were not doing our building, they now said in Lagos, they pay for land. When you do foundation, you pay. When you do level, you pay. You know, when you are rich, you compromise. When the last couple have been paid, not even money to do the project. Somebody has some money there. I said, what have to say? They asked them. So I now said to them, I said, me myself, I'm an area pastor. The pastor of area boy pastor. I said, me myself, I'm an area pastor. So the man will always come to sight when I'm not around. So one day he met Livingstone and he removed 2 blocks. I said, Livingstone, what did you do? He said, I cost him. I said, how did you cost him? He said, every block you remove will scatter his family. I said, you're a disappointment. Livingstone, you're a disappointment. So fortunately for the guy, he thought I would have left church one Sunday. He said his name was made of them. He came in. When I heard his noise from outside, I came out. I met him. I said, are you the man that came to remove block? And for every single block remove here. You are removing each member of your family from heart. Say, my father, it is what your child will eat and your child has come from. We have not got it to that level. It is what we will eat. No, 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 it's not like that. You just came and said you are the owner of the land. I said, are you God? I said, why do not remove again? But why? Then, Papa, me. That's how we finish building. How we finish building? No, no, no. When you are drunk, you are like a crazy man. No pamphlet, no approval. Nothing. We don't draw our team with the Bible. This is how we want the thing to be. This is how the thing will be. That morning, just came and put eggs on the toilet. I came again and announced on Sunday. Ladies and gentlemen, you have the testimony of the first man. We want to keep people in that line. You have friendly people in front of my people are better because I'm starting their meeting tomorrow night. My assistant came again and said, Pastor, our family friend, the father is the director. I said, why was the father of your family friend when you were marking eggs? I said, Pastor, wait till Monday. Me and Bola will be there by Monday. We'll be there by Monday. He went. The director then said, hey, it must be this boy from Musho. I don't have a with church. Oh, tell your pastor, this one is coming. That they should give anything they want to build. So when they return, I say, oh yeah, we are carrying on. We finish that one. Now that's it. Let us do approval for paper. This approval something. They not send paper to Lausa. They came back. When they came, they said, since we have built, they said, I said, okay, how much will we pay? And they said, this no, no, we can't talk it here. I said, will you drink much? They said, no. Fortunately, it was service day. And altar and office, they are joined together. So the window of the altar and the people like this, will be seeing it. And I was talking to this, I was a very complete, totally gentle person. Simple. And they were pressed. I said, and I went, okay. I just go to the DVD. I opened my Bibles, I started. Started taking all those scriptures of the teacher of wicked. I would not be throwing it in. Then we worship, we pray. When we enter, they say, ha, that's why we check about the sermon. It's not like that. Any amount you want to say for pastor, let's advise you. I say, on what? Say, okay, you know the land here is small. So we just approve it for pastoral. You pay. Okay, tell us how much you want us to write. How much you want us to write. I said, but it's your job, your government people, I want to take you. Anything you like, you do. But anybody that will frustrate us here, not only him, his wife, his children, his relatives, as a pastor, no, we are not here to frustrate you, which we are Christians. Well, while God told me before that his name was Jimon, now he has become another name, he gave me another Christian name, sir. You know that we was also before was he to say Christian, sir. Without rich. And that's okay, and I say, so I'm not going to tell that Christian. How much can we afford just to say 100,000? They were telling me because the structure is already there that anything left that can come in. I said, where will you get that? I said, anybody that will stretch me on this thing, they will bury it before this project is done. Now, what makes the difference? What made the difference? And the members were telling me they are, Pastor, don't worry, don't stress yourself. That is Lagos. I said, I'm from London. And the art is the Lord and the fullness. I'm building on God's property. God is the owner of the art, and the church is God. Any couple, I will give them. When we got to the roof, we are even roof before we started putting the blocks. They came one time, they said, this is something for the area of the community. I said, area. I said, try not to meet me. So when Major told them, said, that man, Major told them that they have one man is there, they call him pastor, but it's not normal. It's not normal. That's how the church stood till date. God approval without stress. Listen, there are certain things in your life that will not work until power, much power, be given by it. Be given by it. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So what does it take to get it? Every change comes on the platform of thirst, hunger, and payment of price. Every change is a thing that comes on the platform of thirst, hunger, and pay the price. Pay the price. These were days that we were doing vigil literally almost every day. And the church meets every Friday. Every Friday. One day we did 40 days. We were fasting. We will do service in the evening, we will do service in the night, we will still do fishing. We will go to Colombia number 77. It was craving. You know why the neighbors were happy? They were happy because where we bought, where we built the church, was where area boys, hire killers, they used to meet and put their loads and then where they used to hire them from. So we opened the church with 40 days vigil, night vigil, with microphone, everything. We were a nuisance. Even the loot. Because Canal was one separate loss and loot. We were a nuisance. In fact, me myself, I knew we were in that. But the neighbors, they kept signal to them. They said, we thank you very much. So I started asking, why are they thanking us? You know, you are a nuisance and they are thanking you. And I said, before you came to this place, hire killers, armed robbers, this is their den. This was their den. I said, good. God will give you power that whatever is meant to trouble your peace will end up being swallowed for yourself. So what about this tech? So the platform of that song that paid the price. So be desperate for it. So more power of the Holy Spirit. Be what?
Be
desperate for it. And me, I don't like this power thing. You don't want to get to the top. You want to go every day of progress in life. What will be done without the power of the Holy Ghost? Jesus could not even do good without being anointed with the Holy Ghost and with His power. So how do you want to make it in life in this crooked and perverse generation without being endued? But pastor, unbelievers are enjoying. You are the one who saw them, they are enjoying. We who are pastors, no one liberated them. It costs you something much more demanding. Remember there was an account of somebody who wanted to buy. When he saw the move of the Spirit, he said, I give you money. Let me have it. Simeon the sorcerer. He wanted to buy. The man gave him another sample of the anointing. You know, signs and wonders, there is positive and negative. When the man broke blind, is that a positive one? What's a negative one? Gave him the man power. But his past issue of money, you have to crave for it. You have to what?
Crave
for it. It's like I need it desperately. You know the way those who are involved in all these crack cocaine drugs, when they don't have it, their body will begin to shake. That's why you'll be hungry at any price. They say $100,000, you are ready to pay just to have shots. So you are craving for it, whatever it takes. God, give it to me. Give it to me. Ask and you shall be given. Seek and you shall find. But what do I need for? I don't want to become a pastor. Devil does not know whether you're a pastor or a church member. He only respects power. In Acts chapter 8, verse 16 to 20, Simeon wanted it for money. In Matthew chapter 25, verse 9, remember the account of the 10 virgins. 5 had oil in their lamp, 5 doesn't have. The bride has, the bride grew also in has gone. So yeah, let's share now. It is more pleasant to give than to receive. Be your brother's keeper. Say, go to the seller so that you may know for all of us. You know, if you get your own, I get my own. The ministers get their own. When we come together, what happened to the city?
Fire.
Explosion, fire. So that I won't be taken from your own self. If all of us have full tank and we are heading in the journey of life, none of us will be stranded as a result of fire. But if only the pastor has full tank, the ministers carry three quarter tank, and the church members are now on his arm. And they say, oh, let's go. What do you got to the pastor? This must we do self training today? You know they said to you, Lord. It's because there is no fear. Hey! Must we do discipline and stick on one night? Lack of fear. Bad fear. No power, no energy. Wait, this man will kill us all. Training for 13 weeks and he's still saying the slavers is not yet covered. I will drop out. You will be a dropout.
Amen.
Because you will carry full tank.
Amen.
God was telling me this morning while I was praying. He said, when the cell system starts, let everybody involved in the cell and your ministers to begin to do 12 to 1, the first 7 days, 7 days in a month. You wake up in your house, you will pray 12 to 1, 7 days every month. That one is serious. Don't resign. You just will ask, but also if I don't do, I'm God, he will show your results. He will show your results. It's like a person say, you need English and maths. Say, for where? I'm done with maths. He wants to read a Kansas City University. If you show, same prayer, it's one prayer, they will give you one paper. You wake up 12 to 1, every day, 7 days. You can't do that thing continuously and you stand before people, things will not happen. Never. 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 Because nobody will answer you if there's no proof. All these are, hey, man of God, good man of God. If there's no proof, he said, God will do it, say, for where? For where? Praise the Lord. Praise thanks for your confidence. Now, two questions. Do you want more anointing in your life?
Yes, sir.
I can only hear from people here.
Yes,
sir. Second question. Do you want to grow in power?
Yes, sir.
Oh, sir. The one I've just taken, God, I've not even used it. You think it's a Ashwabi? It's not Ashwabi. That what makes life to tick. The enemy does not want to know whether you're troubling or not. He just wants to know. Man of God was sharing with me this afternoon when he had to go and build church in the den of people who are smoking him and then selling him. So he now gave them money to relocate, 5,000, 10,000 like that. So one now decided to go and expand his own shack. So now told the man, that's a, I gave you money to move. You know, say, sir, I've been here before they bought you. So the man was annoyed, the man of God was annoyed, and now said to him, he said. So the man was just ranking. Now said to the man, I said, Sabi that the person will get there, they reach house. 2 days after, armed robbers stole from a Kurudu one car. They were pursuing them. They just stopped there around the day. They abandoned the car and ran. They had riot, they go rapid response were pursuing. This man, when he had a rapid response, he ended up going and lie down. One of the policemen came back and was pursuing something, shot his 2 legs and went ahead to go and pursue their robbers and left him there. Now he needed help. No leg. Bullet has entered leg. No leg to enter house. He has no choice. The church helped him, but he had to relocate. He didn't relocate by peace. He relocated by fire, by bullet. He said another one. They were smoking and he was gathering them. He said one was smoking, they called him, he said he has not smoking, he denied it. So one day now caught him smoking, they think the spirit has already possessed him and his friend. Now went to him and said, and I saw you entering a pit that you are about to leave. Let me shake your hand. He said, ah, what is your wound there? Get away. The man stretched his hand second time. He told the man of God, get away. The man gone. 2 days after, he was crossing a space. Calculated two of them. The other friend died instantly. His own leg was damaged. They took him to Gobi. Gobi had to do first aid and return him because nobody to take care of him. He came back to the church during when the pastor was preaching, lifted up his hand that he should look at what happened to him and that he wants to ask for forgiveness from the church and from the pastor and to tell everybody.